Well, that's going to cause a little bit of a braking problem. Extremely lubricated brakes on here. That is definitely a leaky wheel seal. And looks like the brakes are out of adjustment too, judging by how far that push rod is pushed out right now. But I'm going to actually get a measurement on them in just a minute. Had to put some steel under here to get it to jack up. The ground was just sinking like crazy. Even with my little 12 by 12 pad, that wasn't cutting it. But we're gonna get in here and see. He's been complaining about almost going off the shoulder a couple times to be able to stop and not hit somebody, and that's, I knew I was gonna find braking problems in the rear. So as you can see, those are all grease and oil covered. And even inside the brake drum is literally oil covered in there. And the reason you see one side and one side not is because the S-cam bushings are bad. So I can put a pry bar under the S-cam here and you can see how much wiggle there is there. So when the brakes tweak on, that allows the shoes to tweak sideways. So one half of one side gets more pressure than the other one. They're not distributing the force equally, if that makes sense to you. So the brake can shoe thing tweaks sideways, so only part of the surface on the outside touches and the inside doesn't, or vice versa. So I ordered new S-cam bushing seals for the S-cam, and then wheel seals. Just gotta get everything here cleaned up. That amount of grease inside the brake is just crazy. Okay, we'll see how the wheel bearings are adjusted back here. Definitely some metal in there. That's not good. Actually can't get it off. The hub doesn't want to pull off. It's like welded on there. It's gonna take some work here. The inner dual wheel on here is 100% flat also. So I would recommend using a tire pressure monitor system to keep an eye on your tires, or test the pressures every time. But those inner ones are a pain to get to, so I understand why people don't do it, but that one was totally flat and lucky didn't tear everything up under here. We just tried a slide hammer on here to get that and didn't even budget, so we're gonna try something a little different now. That thing is definitely seized on there. So we're moving this truck out of the way so that we can use the backhoe as a puller on the hub. This is some seriously sketchy stuff, but that thing is seized on there and those bearings are black, and I could not get by hand that inner nut off of the wheel bearing. The backhoe, the hub. Shooting myself. Oh,
We got the porta power hooked up. We're already replacing everything, so we're using the S-cam as a anchor point there. I think we're bypassing the porta power.
Do we need to hook the tractor back to it?
Oh geez, that's as hard as you can push in that porta power.
Yeah, it's bypassing, I can hear it. We've hit the pressure limit of the porta power.
That's a 10 ton, so that's 20,000 pounds.
Huh. Tearing the cage apart so we can try to pull the bearing, the rollers out.
Plate for the lighter.
I was gonna use the jack, but yeah, that don't matter. Just something that throws sparks. Okay. Get a little settling going. Hey, that bearing was really in there.
No kidding.
Hey, bearing's out.
I did not expect it to pop out of there like that.
Me neither, but it's out.
I can't believe we didn't get any molten steel on us.
You got gloves.
So, yeah. Well, that part should be too hot, but yeah, now it comes off. So it was definitely the outer one. That's...
I'm setting it down like that.
So how does that look in there?
Actually, they don't look bad. Impressive. Sweet.
Well, that race is junk. Which I had already ordered all races and bearings. But you can see some serious issues that was in the underneath of there. I assume that the rollers are going to look like that too. Where it's just falling apart. The inside of it, you can see where it's spun. I don't know how well you can see. And it's been really hot in there.
Tools, check the air and all those duels. It's that bus grease monkey, don't you know? Well, he's got a long, hard ride in old Lenny the Silver Sides. Get that bus grease monkey on the road. Well, he's got that hammer down and that 47 hound. It's that bus grease monkey on the road. He travels all around and he's coming to your town. Get that bus grease monkey down the road. With the propped up engine door, watch that bus grease monkey do his thing. 30 years behind that barn, cause it don't run worth a darn. Watch that bus grease monkey make it sing. He knows them Detroits, there's no doubt, upside down and inside out. It's that bus grease monkey, don't you know? Saving buses, firing wine in that old blue silver sides. It's that bus grease monkey, don't you know? Now he's moved his family to the hills of Tennessee. Watch that bus grease monkey make his home, bringing buses back to life with the help of his dear wife. Watch that bus grease monkey get it done. When he travels town to town working on them old greyhounds, it's that bus grease monkey, don't you know? Saving buses, firing wide, and old Lenny the silver sides. It's that bus grease monkey, don't you know? It's that bus grease monkey, don't you know? It's that bus grease monkey, don't you know?